No objective American would think any of these deals passed the smell test. We all know about Hunter Biden's dealings with Ukraine, but here recently, his brother is doing TV ads for a law firm, but he's not a lawyer. His sister's writing a book, but she's not an author. And now we find out that Hunter's new side gig is he's an artist selling art that looks to me like something you would see on the bargain shelf at TJ Maxx for prices as high as $500,000 to undisclosed donors. So the Republicans on the House Oversight Committee have requested information from the White House about all these transactions, specifically Hunter Biden's and who exactly is purchasing this artwork at such inflated prices.
Yeah, I mean, we all know how it goes, right, Congressman? So someone calls up the gallery and says, I want to buy this, you know, $200,000. And then they call up Hunter Biden, maybe they know him, and they say, oh, Hunter, I like your painting. You know, it's kind of expensive at $200,000. And he leaves it at that, and then maybe a couple months later, Hunter, I got this, you know, thing going on in West Virginia. I'd love to meet with some folks at the White House. Can you help me out? I mean, that's how it'll go, right? Something like that.
Something like that. And the White House tried to defend that by saying that Hunter Biden has a right to pursue his dreams. And I agree with that. He has a right to pursue his dreams, even though the Democrats didn't think the Trump children had a right to pursue their business interests that they started decades before Donald Trump ever thought about getting into politics. But the problem with what Hunter Biden's doing is there are so many questions as to potential conflicts of interest. Are these government contractors that are purchasing this art? Is this communist China purchasing this art? The American people deserve to know, and a president has ethical standards that they're supposed to abide by. You're not supposed to profit from being in the White House. And when you look at Joe Biden's family, this is a pattern of these siblings and his son trying to profit from his last name dating back to when he was vice president.
Well, we know that Jared and Ivanka lost a lot of money when they went in to work for the government. By one account, $36 million drop in income. Obviously, some of the hotels are, you know, had some problems even before COVID because of all the boycotts and so forth. So they were losing money, and then the Bidens get rich while their dad is in office. And so it kind of reminds me of the Clinton Global Initiative and all that we saw there. It's kind of their version of the Clinton Global Initiative with a paintbrush, I guess.
It is. And when you look at the Trumps, they were in business decades before. They were credible business people. The Bidens were not. I mean, the fact that Joe Biden's brother is advertising for a law firm and he's not even an attorney. I have a lot of attorney friends in Kentucky that work for big law firms. They don't know of any employees advertising on television for the law firm who aren't attorneys. And this is something that doesn't need to happen. We've got a lot of questions with respect to why Biden's not standing tougher on China. You know, doesn't the Biden administration want to do investigations into the origination of COVID? But, you know, he won't disclose who these donors are.
Yeah, we need full transparency.
A lot of people are wondering, is it China? Right?
Full transparency needed. Congressman, thank you.